Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mangus, and I welcome you guys to part 4 of Let's Play Civilization 5, A Brave New World, playing as Ramses of the Egyptian Empire. Let us continue our journey. Yes, let us continue our journey. So, what has been happening here? Well, we've kind of been, you know, building us up a little bit in terms of social policy. We just put a point into piety, and I do mean to get some burial tombs up in here. We are also exploring this ledge right here and, you know, defending a little bit from Theodora. Not really doing a whole lot. I guess we could raid Dido a little bit. That sounds fun, don't you guys think? See what she has over here. We can pillage, have some fun. Although we gotta be careful of enemy knights. That could be a little bit scary. Also, if Dido somehow allies with Yerevan, that could be very bad for me. But yeah, I need to work on my science, and I've thought about, I'm not sure if I said it in the last part because it's been 2 days since I made a recording, but I'm gonna go for Jesuit education. I haven't seen anyone pick it yet. No, I don't think so. I don't see Jesuit education here. Somebody took heathen conversion. What the hell? No, I don't think anyone has grabbed Jesuit education, which is why I'm going to try to go for Reformation, to get a Reformation belief. At least that's the plan. And hopefully, let's see if we can make something happen. Also, I'm kind of working on a plantation. I'm probably going to build a road around Heliopolis and Lysanthebes just to be able to send people out. And also, I can't embark on my scouts. That is actually a big problem. After education, I'm probably gonna have to go for optics, and then we probably need workshops, because, yeah, workshops are a thing. Also, I'm gonna send some, food to Thebes, I think, just growing it a little bit, and I am actually gonna run around and have some fun. Are we at war with the city-state? I do believe we are. Yep, we definitely are. Might as well get some experience, right? Let me go and pillage Dido's improvements, you know, just to be a little bit of a dick, get some money. And what are we going to do here? Well, let's build a floodplain. We have our bison, so we are happy. Yeah, I think I'm going to try to get burial tombs in all of my cities. That would certainly help my happiness out a lot. The burial tombs are pretty nice, and we can get them so fast. We're currently saving up for a great prophet, which we'll be using pretty much just to spread our religion around. Probably going to pick my... I'm pretty sure my religion will spread to Elephantine soon enough, but I can spread it to Heliopolis, Memphis, Novgorod, and Moscow. Probably sounds like a good idea. Alright. And would you look at that, the Great Prophet is already here. Alright, let us pillage a little bit. Like so. We could go in, pillage a farm, and then go out again. Sounds nice. Alright, let's go and spread our religion. And we can probably go and pillage some improvements down. Let's send this chariot archer to join the raid. This archer can go into Heliopolis, I think. And what I'm going to do is now is I'm going to connect a road from Heliopolis to Thebes on the south mountain range, because that can actually really help in sending reinforcements quicker. I also plan on expanding here once I have the happiness for it, which I currently don't. I would love a garden, actually. Or the Great Mosque of Jen. That would also be nice. But I should perhaps go for the... I'm going to buy my last library and go for the National College before I do anything else. Because it's about freaking time we grab the National College. It's actually pretty pathetic we haven't gotten it yet. I think... Oh, we have unemployed citizens. That's not good. Let's spend them right here. That's a little bit better. Let's grab that burial tomb. We want to get the burial tombs up everywhere now. And have we... We have enhanced our religion, haven't we? I'm pretty sure we have. No, we have not. Maybe we should enhance our religion instead of spreading it. I don't know. Should we? That is actually a good question. Because we will get extra gold if we spread it immediately. You know what? Maybe I should enhance my religion instead. That might actually be better. I'm not sure. How when I will I get my next prophet? You know what? I think I'll spread my religion. Just because Tide is so amazing, you know? Oh, would you look at that? We can disrupt some of Theodora's... we can disrupt some of her missionaries. Ain't that nice? Oh, would you look at that? That's a lot of missionaries, actually. Let's go fuck them up. Alright, send you over here. We're just waiting with our scouts until we can get optics, because I kind of want to embark with these guys. Also, I'm considering just getting open borders with Shaka so I can keep exploring down here. That might just be worth it, and I don't know if Shaka still hates my guts. I hope he doesn't. Anyway, we did some damage to Dido. That's always nice. You should also always go on raids to pillage. I should also grab chivalry so I can actually upgrade my shit. And would you look at that? Theodora is sending missionaries. Dido is sending missionaries. We should totally like... Oh, she might be looking to get a quest here, actually. That would be pretty bad. Oh, wow. What happened to my luxuries? Holy shit. Alright, Shaka. You're a good friend, right? Did Shaka just call me the bloodthirsty one? You know you're fucked if he calls you bloodthirsty. Yeah, no, that's way too much. Okay, so who doesn't hate me? Korea, pretty much. He calls my military the laughingstock of the world? What did I ever do to him? Nope, I really have no good trading partners whatsoever. Oh, I captured the missionary. That's not exactly what I wanted to do. Alright, let's grab organized religion. So that's some extra faith. Wow, our happiness is not looking good right now. So, who did we lose a trade? Sejong. Wine. Sejong. Yeah, he is... that was kind of our deal, wasn't it? Alright, you attack that. We don't want to let Dido spread her religion to Yerevan, because it might just be that she has some sort of quests. And then she might become allied with Yerevan, and that would be really fucking bad for us. That would be really fucking bad. Oh, so he wants to trade now. How about... No, I don't. I really want to buy a luxury from him. How about this? That's a very, very good deal for him. Okay, did she manage to convert Yerevan? Fuck, she managed to do it. If she has a quest with Yerevan, she might actually get them as allies now, which is really bad for us. Let's just delete these missionaries. We don't really need them. And, ooh, would you look at that? Iron, cool. Alright, let's go and shoot these guys down. Like so. It's always nice, some nice experience to get. Also, just gonna go on a hunt for barbarian encampments, because they usually pop up in places like this. Just grab a farm. Why not? Right, what should we grab right here now? A garden would probably be nice. Or a circus. Circus also works. I think we're gonna grab a circus, actually. Do something about these guys. Maybe I should just fortify a warrior up on the citadel. Maybe that'll work. Alright. Spread our religion. I'm gonna get another prophet real soon, so should be fine. Oh, cool. We can upgrade the pikeman. That's probably a good idea, all things considered. Oh, we could send a pikeman to fortify on the citadel. You know, just in case Dido gets allied with Yerevan. That's probably a good idea, actually. Because Yerevan's gonna pillage our improvements if they go to war with us. Ah, spilled Pepsi Max on my shirt. Fuck. Hate it when I do that. You know what? Yes, we're gonna send some pikemen over to that fort. What is going on here? Alright, let's kill that. Hell yeah, let's keep raiding. Some damage to these guys as well. Alright, so we're... Okay, let's send the pikemen over here. It's gonna take them 3 turns. Grab the iron. Build the farm. Let's just go on a hunt for barbarian encampments. See if they're here. Alright. And you guys can fortify up here, that's fine. Right, so what do we want in Memphis right now? I guess actually what would be nice would be just to get some internal trade routes going. But I have a feeling like we're still gonna suffer with happiness. So I'm gonna grab those Colosseums. In this city, we have the burial tomb, I do believe, so that's good. This city. Doesn't really matter what kind of production we have. We could lock this tile, though. You know, just to get a little bit more production. Let's grab a water mill for the extra production. Could help. And here we could grab the granary. Don't know what I'm going to do with this warrior. It's kind of redundant at this point. But if I could fortify the pikeman up on the citadel, then that'd be really nice. Because Yerevan is going to probably try to pillage my shit if Dido allies with them. And I'm pretty sure that Dido is going to try and do that. Kaja Maja is saying mean things to me. Mommy, make him stop. Such a bully, that guy. Eventually, the AIs are going to start expanding on this area right here because it's very open. There's also salt here, which leads me to believe that, you know, could be an idea to try and grab some of this shit. This is a hill, sadly. Alright, doesn't seem to be anything particularly interesting happening here. Anyway, I send the pikemen over to the citadel. And what are we doing here? Alright, we're building a road. Yeah, we're gonna keep building that road. Let's go explore to the north there. There's actually an area we haven't discovered yet. We're spreading our religion. That gives us a lot of nice juicy cash. Always so lovely. But yeah, getting chivalry would be really nice. Just upgrading all of these guys to knights. I have 6 horses, so... We could get 6 really powerful knights, actually, with great promotions on them. Like, they have amazing accuracy promotions. I'm guessing those get converted, right? Surely they do. We won't, like, get knights with with ranged combat strength. That would be pretty hilarious, actually. So I really hope that's not the case. Alright, build a road. And let's expend the last use of our great profits. Nothing here. I'm kind of just patrolling back and forth, see what I can see. I can't really do a whole lot with these units, but if I see some stray units from Dido, I'm going to kill them. I could definitely do something about Antioch, but it's in a very defensible location. And until I get stronger units, there's not a whole lot I can do. Oh my god. Sulu's Shaka is going absolutely crazy. He's taking Edinburgh. Yep. You're fucked, Boudica. You're pretty fucked, all things considered. Holy crap, we haven't even gotten our first spy yet. We are really not very technologically advanced. Alright, let's back up. It's about time we fortify these pikemen. Spread our religion. And we can kind of just hang around here until we can figure out something better to do. I'm probably going to go for chivalry after I'm done with metal casting. That actually sounds like a fantastic idea. I really want to get those knights up. Alright, so the garden probably would be a nice idea. Yeah. We could also grab the stable for... Actually, I think the stable would be really nice because we have 2 copies of... that's horses, cattle, and sheep. So that will actually grant us 1, 2, 3... Yeah, 3 hammers. That's pretty good, actually, in terms of production. We probably want that. Yeah, would you look at that? Barbarians. Let's get even more experience. Actually, you don't get any experience past level 3, so I guess it's kind of redundant, but... Oh, would you look at that? Pearls. Anyway, we're going to grab education now. That's great. We might build a university in Thebes. Probably a good idea. Our science is pretty appalling, but that's why I'm getting Jesuit education. We have now 13 turns to the next policies. It's going to take some time to get reformation. I also think I'm going to grab theocracy, to be quite honest, because the extra gold from all of my burial tombs is pretty insane. Alright, we have education. That's wonderful. Let's work on this road. And grab another farm. Get another farm. We also have the Great Wall, which is actually kind of cool. Mustn't forget about that. Alright, chariot archers can just hang out It's really annoying me that I can't make peace with Theodore or Dido. They're kind of being annoying like that. Also, these pikemen have drill promotion. Not the best, but I guess they can grab... I'm expecting Dido to ally with Yerevan because it's very close to her. And it would make a lot of sense for her to do so. And Yerevan is still pretty pissed with me. So... Oh, nice. A new unit from Valera. I really like that I'm getting all these units, although it's just crappy catapults for now. Alright, now I do believe I can embark. So I can send my scouts down here. Alright, let's shoot on the barbarians. Why not? Currently, I demand citrus. I don't think anyone has citrus. Pretty sure they don't. Nope. We really need to meet some of the other AIs. I don't really know where they are, but if I could grab myself a caravel, I could go explore. We'll see how that goes. I have absolutely no one to trade with. I can trade with these city-states, but they don't really give me anything. And I kind of like... they want me to demand tribute from Genoa. I could go do that. If I position my military... You know what? I could go do that. I could go demand tribute from Genoa. They don't seem to be under protection of anyone, so... Maybe we should go do that. You know, I think that's a fantastic idea, actually. Let's go position our military outside Genoa and demand a tribute from them. It's one of those quests you nearly never do. Let's see how it goes. If we come with catapults and shit, then that might actually work out. Alright, let's finish the road. Let's send the composite bowman. I think the more units you send, the greater likelihood is that the tribute will succeed. I do believe the quality of those units also matters, and I think the great general also helps. Let's go make them afraid of us. That sounds like something that we could definitely do. Grab the watermill for that sweet production and food. We could also upgrade the swordsman. We have the iron for it, so might as well. Our warriors are kind of crap, so I don't think that's a particularly bad idea. We actually have a lot of iron to sell, but because of the warmongering penalty, we won't get anything from it. But I think eventually Shaka will start forgiving us, because Shaka does tolerate warmongering. It would also be nice to get that silk. He calls me bloodthirsty. You believe that? He wants to give me... Oh, let's see, actually, if Shaka is interesting in... Yeah, he is interested in buying iron. And he wants to give me open borders for it. But he's only interested in buying 5 iron. Sure. You know what? I want open borders with him. So I can keep exploring here. Alright, keep going over here. So now we will start making Genoa afraid of us. Maybe not so much, considering war chariots are pretty crap, but, you know, you never know. Could work. I really want to demand tribute from them. That's a pretty nice... That's a lot of influence we could get from Valera. And who knows, maybe we can get some gold from them, too. Alright, we're done with the road. That's great. Let's work on some farms. Upgrade the warriors. So I think you need to actually move your military into... Oh, hello, Maspa. Oh, there's actually more stuff down here. Interesting. So, the question is, do they share my military enough for this shit to actually work? We'll see. They might. Go grab another floodplains. Or another farm, more likely. Alright, let's see if they're intimidated by this or not. I also have a chariot archer here I'm going to send over. It would help if I had knights. This might not be enough to scare them. They might just get pissed, really. Alright, cool. Spy has been recruited. Wonderful. Antwerp has declared war on me. Who's that? No one close, so I don't really care. Okay, they're currently just angry at me. Alright, we don't have any slots for this political writer, but that's fine, because I'm just gonna... I really need that reformation belief. So...
All right, let's see if we can rattle them.
This is actually not so. Actually, I was just about to say it's not a bad expansion, but then it is actually a pretty bad expansion. Come on, look at all my catapults. Fear me. So, do they fear my military yet? Let's see. They do not fear you're my military. We'll see about that. I'm kind of putting all my eggs in one basket now. They really should fear my military. But they have quite a strong military themselves. So. Oh! Hello, Napoleon! Oh, that's so refreshing. He doesn't have a lot of shit, though. I am France. It is Napoleon, and he is right here. It's gonna be nice to get a new trading partner. Wonderful. Fear me, goddammit, Genoa. Ugh, I only get trespassing bonuses. Wellington has declared war on me. Someone is really doing some work here. Come on, fear my military, goddammit. I have a freaking great general here. Apparently, they don't really seem to care all that much. Maybe I just have to position my military outside their borders. I'm actually not sure how that even works. And why can I not embark? I got optics. God damn it. Alright, well, I guess they simply do not fear me. Alright, we can finally get the Grand Temple. That's wonderful. Great Mosque of Gen, maybe? I don't think so. I think I'll grab the garden for the happiness boosts. And let's grab religious tolerance. Again, we get a pantheon, but I don't really know how to check it out. So. Well, it would appear that Genoa doesn't really fear my military at all. Unmet player are now allies. Okay. How does that work? Oh, Yerevan. Oh. Yerevan allied with someone. Interestingly enough, I don't really know who, but they did. Well, that city state doesn't produce any silver anymore. I only get trespassing bonuses. Maybe I'm not doing this right. Maybe I just need to place them outside their borders. I really don't know. Or it could just be that my military simply... Like, these are freaking war chariots. It could be that once I get knights... Then things get a little bit better. Well, I've officially destroyed my relationship with these guys. So, there's that. I think just placing your units on the city-state itself does help a lot. But yeah, war chariots are simply not advanced enough to do anything. I'm just gonna take a turn of research, because I do plan on building workshops in these cities immediately. This is probably not gonna give me a lot of science. I almost never do this, but sometimes it's actually not so bad to do this. If you don't have anything better to do with the city, you might as well just put it to research. Not really interested in that, my friend, but I would be interested in 14 gold per turn. And, oh, how lovely to trade with someone who I don't have a warmonger penalty with. That is like a breath of fresh air. Holy shit. Alright, oh cool. I can get a great profit now. Wonderful. We can enhance that religion. And I'm pretty sure I know what kind of enhancement beliefs... Oh, I didn't place my spy. What a fucking moron I am. Yeah, that's going to Constantinople. That was kind of embarrassing. You kind of want to place your spy immediately. It's one of the things you want to do super quick. Let's go grab a farm over here. Yeah, this ain't working. This just isn't working. So, fine. You know what? We'll just send our units back. Maybe once we've upgraded them. I have this habit of placing my units in cities. It's not really necessary now that I actually don't have the Ogliarchy opener. Or the Ogliarchy Tenant, which gives you free maintenance. It's actually kind of useless to do it, but... I don't know. I still like to do it. And I think I went one turn too much with the research. That's a little bit embarrassing as well. Being a little bit too quick in ending my turn right now. Okay, I'm going to lose Valletta because I didn't have enough military to actually demand tributes. That sucks, actually, because Valletta's been giving me a lot of free units. Oh, well. I got a little bit of extra science out of it. It's not the end of the world. We're traveling one day. Hope we can steal some text from Theodora. That'd be nice. There's our great prophet. Just so I don't forget, I'm going to switch over to workshop production now. I think I want... I definitely want workshops in all of my cities. But I'm going to let the Grand Temple finish, though. All right, let's enhance our religion. And I see some floodplains farms that we can take advantage of right now. All right, so, this is the trade I want. Choral music, temple generate 2 culture. That is pretty much insane. I mean, Feed the World is also pretty darn nice, but I need more culture to get my Reformation belief. And as far as the Enhancer belief goes, I think since I don't really have that, I might just go for Messiah. Actually, because I could grab some really good holy site if I intend to go full piety. I think I'm going to go Messiah, actually. Get some cheap profits. Because it's not like I have anything else to buy with my religion, so it's pretty much just profits all the way. So that could actually work. Enemy denunciation of you has expired. I don't even remember who that was. But yeah, we want workshops in all of our cities. Thebes, Elephantine. And I'm also eventually going to consider expanding over here. Just to get the whales and another coastal city. Yaruman is declared war on me. Okay, it happened. It happened. Right there, I knew it would happen eventually. Alright, so that kind of sucks. We need to send some units now to protect our stuff. We do luckily have the citadel, thank god. Let's grab the composite bowman over here. So let's send the great general over here as well. What is this? Oh, we got some city-state pikemen wandering about. Let us see what we can do about them. Maybe we could just straight up kill them. There we go. Yeah, that works. Can send these guys as well. Really don't want to lose our citadel. I don't think we will, but still. Alright, cool. We could grab cover. Let's just keep fortifying. Grab workshops. Yeah, sending our war chariots over here seems like a good idea. So, I just hope I can prevent them from pillaging my silver. These pikemen are going to get hit pretty hard now. But they do have cover, so they might be able to hold out until reinforcements arrive. Hello, Shaka. You like horses? Actually, I like horses. Maybe you're willing to do this? Oh. No. What did you want? What kind of deal did you want again? 5 gold per turn. That's fine. I can definitely do that. Yeah, Shaka's gonna be a big menace if he's allowed to keep conquering civilizations at this speed. It's fine. My pikemen will be just fine. Hell, I could even get some experience of this city state right here. Does Genoa hate me, or are we actually at war? No, they just hate me. So I tried to demand tribute from them. Alright, you know what? Let's have some fun. Let us have some fun. Do we need any more improvements around here? I do believe we can build farms on these desert tiles now that I have Petra here. So they're kind of just like plains tiles. That's wonderful. Our happiness, again, is not looking fantastic. I will get my garden here, so that works, but I think I need some trades. Would you look at that? You want some iron? Boudica usually loves her iron, and she will, so that is wonderful. 7 gold per turn. We do have a lot of iron. That's good. We just need someone to sell them to. I could try to sell my iron to Napoleon, actually. Ugh. My chariot archers, they get killed so insanely fast. I could crush the city-state, actually. That'd be kind of fun. Hey. Get away. Alright, let's crush it. There we go. have some fun with the city-state, get some experience. Alright, we don't need to send all of our units over here. That's a little bit too much. We definitely want some units spread around in case barbarians show up. Alright, let's grab that workshop. 4 turns. Moscow actually got very decent production, I must say. What does our spy say? Theodora is plotting against Boudica. You don't say. Wait, Jakarta? Did she take... I do believe she took Indonesia's capital. Share our intrigue to get a bonus with Boudica. Hey, Jakarta. That's kind of funny, actually. Shaka takes Boudica's capital. And she takes... Indonesia's capital. Kind of funny. But yeah, thanks to choral music, we are now getting a decent amount of culture from all our burial tombs. I think I might just go ahead and max out the piety tree. I mean, I will get insanely good holy sites. I can get some really freaking good holy sites. Oh no, my scouts. Yeah, it was bound to happen eventually, I suppose. Valletta's made peace with Wellington. No longer ally of Valletta. Aw. Yep, it was bound to happen eventually. Goodbye, free units. It was certainly nice while it lasted. I am pretty sure my chariot archers gets absolutely decimated by... oh, cool, we could pillage this tile. Why not? I'm pretty sure I get absolutely decimated by that city-state. 40 range combat strength. I don't even want to bring my chariots close to that. But in 4 turns, we can upgrade them all to knights. And that should be pretty effective. We could go on a real raid. We could have a lot of fun in Hippodegus. Hell, we could probably just crush Yerevan. Yeah, we probably could. But we need a lot of gold, though, to upgrade all those knights. It's going to be a pretty expensive upgrade, probably. Do we want Yerevan? No, it could actually work. You know, just take it. Oh, would you look at that? A barbarian. What have I told you about getting out of our borders? Stupid barbarian. Alright, wonderful. Let's grab another farm. And our scout is now going to explore these lands. It could be that Theodora has cities there, so I need to be a little bit careful. But I think we should be fine. Now, if I could upgrade... Actually, that's a really good idea. I should probably go physics so I can upgrade my catapults to trebuchets. And I can probably just crush Yerevan. Would be nice to crush Antioch as well. I have a lot of things I want to do with these knights, so... I do believe in Vanilla Civ, knights used to cost 1 iron and 1 horse. But they also had a lot more combat strength. I just remembered that. They were pretty darn OP. Alright, so that's good. We get defensive pact treaties. That's not really useful. And castles. I do believe a castle in Heliopolis would be kinda useful. That city is definitely vulnerable towards the late game from a strong naval attack. I am at Prague. Apparently, Prague is down here. Would you look at that? Let's go have a look, and let's keep building farms here. I keep forgetting, these plane tiles are actually insanely good. They are insanely good. Alright, let's see how many upgrades we can afford. I'm probably guessing it's going to be between 100 and 200 gold to get these up to knights, but of course once they do, they become insanely good. And I'm really curious to see what happens to the ranged promotions, actually. Also, are we working Sarah the Potosi? Yes, we are, thank God. We really need to get our happiness up. I really need to get our happiness up, because it's kind of sucky at the moment. See if we can get some. We could probably get some from Shaka. Don't think Sejong wants to sell sugar, but we can try. Actually, that's not so bad. Oh, I just traded my marble, didn't I? I'm an idiot. Well, at least he wants to give me a little bit of gold for my iron. That is always good. He wants to get even more. What a wonderful guy you are. Um, Right. Oh my god, that's way too expensive. Holy crap. Shaka really does not like me. Looks like we're just gonna have to live with our unhappiness. Let's grab a Colosseum. And time to get a workshop here. And would you look at that? Theodora is sneaking around again. What could she be scheming? Yeah, we could just crush Yerevan, really. I mean, that would actually not be such a bad idea, I think. I mean, it's another city, and it's at war with us anyway, so... Of course, I would prefer not to, but... We actually don't have embassies with each other. Do you look at that? Might as well repair my broken relationship with Indonesia slightly. I don't believe... Indonesia actually has a lot of units. I can't believe they aren't taking back Jakarta. They really should. Cool. Pikeman. Wonderful. Alright, time to upgrade. So how expensive is this upgrade? 135 gold. Yeah, that seems completely fine. We have yet another upgrade. Let's grab cover 2 on these bad boys. Do I have any other... Oh, would you look at that? Crossbowmen out on the ocean. Completely exposed. Oh, hello. That's the city-states. Let's continue. We can actually send production to Thebes instead of food. That's probably a better idea, I think. Let's go grab the cattle. Alright, let's grab the workshop. And I don't know how we're going to fix our happiness. I really don't. I'm just going to have to do it somehow. Could grab the forge, maybe. We only have one source of iron. I think, actually, we should get some more caravans up here. Get some more internal trade routes going. We could send a lot of production to Thebes and just churn out a bunch of really awesome buildings. But now we have a lot of knights, so I think that we should definitely go raid. See what we can do. Be some real dicks with these units we have. Zanzibar has declared war on you. Lovely. They just don't stop, do they? Yeah, I say we go and have some fun. Wow, everyone really wants to declare war on me these days. So, let's see. The knights do not retain their movements and their... Wait, they still have accuracy? What? Yeah, you gotta be kidding me right now. What? Oh, so he doesn't get changed? Well, that's garbage. What the hell? Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me right now. Really? They have freaking ranged combat strength. Well, okay, my view on war chariots just worsened. If they retain their freaking ranged promotions, how the hell? At least they can probably get logistics, which means that they can attack twice. Oh, hello, William. For hotter dicker little later, hotter center, one var von Danny Sim Shamstein. I love the way William speaks, it's so fucking awesome. Alright, he didn't have any luxuries to give us, but he had some trades, so that's useful, I suppose. Yeah, I think just pairing a lot of production to Thebes and getting out some key buildings probably is going to be a very important idea. Since we don't have any trading partners, we should definitely try to, Oh, do you look at that? Is William at war with Dido? I am actually not sure. However, I'm gonna have a lot of fun pillaging all these tiles. Well, I must say I am slightly disappointed. Certainly very disappointed. But we're gonna have ourselves a raiding party. Good old-fashioned night raiding party. And also, as soon as I have the economy for it, I'm upgrading my catapults to trebuchets as well. Alright, let's grab these caravans, and it's time to make a proposal, and that is always going to be World's Fair, because, let's face it, the diplomatic bonus makes too much sense. Hell, we might actually consider building World's Fair, We have a lot of gain from that. The extra culture would be insane. Actually, it's without a doubt in my mind we want to get World's Fair. We have a lot of cities, so we can very reliably get the gold medal. And the 100% increased culture is insane. Oh yeah, definitely. Absolutely we want it. Oh yeah. Oh, we want it. Alright, it seems like Yerevan continues to shoot on our composite bowmen. Or, I mean, our pikemen. So we can keep grinding some experience on our composite bowmen. Which is quite nice, actually. Nice. Alright, we've reached the end here. Oh, this is a large map. Alright, let's go raid. Let's go have some fun. It's too bad the knights don't retain their bonus movement. That would have actually made war chariots somewhat decent, at least. But, nope. That would have been too good. We can't have good war chariots. That clearly does not work out. Yeah, let's have some fun with these guys. Hey, catapults actually killed something. Lovely. But yeah, we probably want the other guilds and Thebes as well. And we get a bonus with William. That's great. Maybe a declaration of friendship as in research agreements. That would be really nice. Also, we're going to steal attack in 24 turns. Oh my god, it would be awesome to steal from the Netherlands. But I've been here so long, I kind of want to complete the stealing. 24 turns is quite a long time, but I still would like to do it. Hey, would you look at that? There's some knights over here that I definitely want to kill. Oh my god, yeah, Yerevan doesn't have any iron, so they have a lot of penalties from not having the strategic resources. Hey, would you look at that? Grab another great general. Oh my god, knights are so freaking strong. Holy crap. They're fast. They're strong. They can pillage. Everything about knights is completely freaking awesome. Alright, let's send this one to Moscow, and we definitely need to do something about this barbarian. So, let's actually send this knight up to deal with Van. Lovely, we can get a mine here. Let's upgrade our catapult as well. And with this great prophet, we could either spread our religion, which would be nice. Oh well, apparently we can make peace with Valetta. That's nice to know. Can we make peace with Yerevan? Let's actually check if we can make peace with anyone here. My god. We can. I hate the fact that you don't just do this automatically. Well, apparently we can make peace with a lot of city-states. You look at that. I wish it just did so automatically. Alright, do we have any quests? Okay, we have a quest to denounce the Sulus. I don't know if I want to do that. Alright, I think I know what I want from here. I want a Holy Sites. The Holy Sites aren't amazing immediately, but they get a lot better. Alright, we made peace. That's wonderful. So what do we want to go for now? I'm guessing machinery would be nice. The faster movement on road is actually pretty insane. Then we probably want to make our way up to economics so we can get some windmills. Although, astronomy and exploration... Actually, the observatories would be insane. Yeah, we're going to go for observatories first because we have a lot of cities next to mountains. And we need to work on our pathetic science. Luckily, the Jesuit education should help a lot. We're going to buy so many freaking universities and public schools for all our faith. That's also why I want holy sites, because I want to generate more faith. We are generating an insane amount of faith, actually. 55 faith per turn is absolutely insane. That will be really nice. Alright. Let's grab that holy sites. That's currently only worth 6 faith, but definitely nice to have. And once we fill out the theocracy tree, that will be worth more and more. Let's grab the artist guild. And let us also grab an aqueduct. Hey, fuck off, will you? We're sending a knight to deal with that nonsense. Once we have built that farm, we can go and repair the damage they've caused. Alright, let's do some hit and run strategies. Pillage and then get out of the bombardment range. Pillage and get out. Hit and run. God, I love knights. They're so fancy. And we can now finally get reformation. Well, that was quick. Holy shit. Alright, Jesuit education. Wonderful. Now we can buy public schools. We can buy freaking public schools with faith. That is amazing. So I'm actually just going to queue up universities immediately. They only cost 200 faith, too. That's the best part. Like, they cost so little. Like, depending on how what they do for you. Alright, we're going to send some production to Thebes. That will certainly help in getting our guilds. I do believe I just... Didn't I just... Oh, well, I guess we could send some food to Thebes as well. Or, what we could do is we could... where's Heliopolis? It's all the way down there. We could send some hammers to Heliopolis, actually. That will also spread our religion a little bit, which is quite nice. Which is another added bonus to your trade routes. They kind of help you spread religion. And, you know, kind of helps the production of the workshop a little bit. Four hammers is nothing to scoff at. It's really good. So now we will build the university every fourth turn, which will definitely help our science out by a huge amount. So I'm really happy about that. Just getting Jesuit education is absolutely insane. Next up, I'm just going to fill out the piety tree because my holy sites will be absolutely insane once I've built universities in every single city. I'm just going to keep producing profits, cheap profits, mind you. Oh, I could even steal a worker maybe. Maybe look at that, a settler. All right, let's go and repair the stone quarry that got damaged. I'm not sure what I should do with this pikeman. Probably won't really need him down here, so... Let's keep raiding Dido, shall we? We could maybe force her to sign a peace treaty. That'd be nice. Let's do some damage to these guys. Let's do some damage to the city-states, because why not? And the Dromons are kind of starting to lose their shine now, if I may say so myself. Hell, we should probably send some trebuchets down here. And keep bombarding these ships. Get away, you nasty composite bowmen. We don't want you here. But yeah, we're going to raid the crap out of Dido. Oh crap, these knights are actually in bombardment range. But I think they should be safe because they are knights. They're pretty darn strong. Combat strength of 20 is very powerful. Can basically do whatever the fuck you want. Gonna pillage the shit out of the city-states and the Hippodagus. And once we're done pillaging here, we're gonna send them down to Antioch. We could actually take Antioch if there's no military here, but there probably are. Alright. Ladies and gentlemen, I think this is a good time to end this part. Hope you guys are enjoying it so far. Please consider leaving a like and a comment if you are enjoying it. It helps out the channel tremendously. It really does. And as always, my name has been Mangs, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!